You know, one of the things I was thinking about a couple of days ago was the fact that, you know, I don't know how much this exists on the right. It does to a certain degree. But it really, this problem really exists on the left, and it really exemplifies why the left is, quite frankly, destroying itself. And that is, they can't have any more heroes. And every hero they do have would never make it in these days. I'm just going to pull some random ones out of a hat almost. Look at Che Guevara. There is literally probably not a progressive on YouTube that doesn't have a poster of him, a picture of him, a t-shirt with a silhouette on it. And these people never shut the fuck up day in and day out about how racist, xenophobic, homophobic, transphobic, and whatever other phobe our president is. Meanwhile, the motherfucker they're wearing on their t-shirt was a complete racist and a complete homophobe. Yeah, Che Guevara was a complete racist and a complete homophobe. They probably have quoted Gandhi at some point. Meanwhile, Gandhi was not only a racist, he was also a nationalist. He wanted India for Indians. He did not want Africans in India. He did not like them. Also, he probably would have been Me Too'd a little bit. If you don't know, read up on Gandhi's young girls and, well, just read up on that. You also have to type in the word enema. Then you have Martin Luther King. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., the guy who gave I Have a Dream. Well, what's ironic is I'm going to do an article on this of an explosive new accusation against him. He would have been Me Too'd anyway, because even if these accusations turn out to be bullshit, it's pretty much confirmed that he cheated on his wife with every young college girl he met. Now, granted, these were two consenting adults, but of course, the leftist, progressive, feminist bullshit of, oh, the power dynamics of blah, 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 blah. Now, the accusations leveled recently are a little more serious than that, but you get the point. The problem is, to be a hero in this day and age on the left, you have to be more perfect than Jesus Christ, a mythological figure. And this particularly, and yes, there's heroes on the right that they tend to idealize a little bit more than they should. Like Ronald Reagan, you can make an argument that he could have been found guilty for treason. He also supported gun control. You know, just off the top of my head. But it's particularly damaging to the right. Or to the left, I'm sorry. And this is why you're going to have Trump 2020. And this is why you're going to have Republican most likely 2024. Because they cannot get behind a message. Any message the Democrats have, any message the left has, that's out there, only exists to appease the extreme Twitterati, fucking small, minor, vocal minority. But apparently this extremely small vocal minority has a megaphone the size of Arkansas. And the problem is, progressives, at the very best, make up 8% of the Democratic voting bloc, which is 4 to 2% of the electorate. So, not a thing. Hate to bring this up, but actually, no, I don't. Dear left, you're going to have to start viewing people, or you're going to start having to view people that you put up on a pedestal as people. You're going to stop having to hold everyone to ridiculous standards. And you're also, quite frankly, going to have to start accepting the people that disagree with you, just disagree with you. When you call everyone who is to the right of Lenin fucking alt-right, white nationalist, racist, xenophobic, homophobic, not Nazi assholes, well, you kind of make sure that your party isn't fucking viable. You've already lost 2020. You might want to try to save 2024.